praise Taman Krishna Goswami Maharaj. Now, Maharaj has been teaching in Mayapur Institute since its inception. Without wasting more time, let me move over to Maharaj so that all devotees can learn about the significance of Gunicha Mahajan from Maharaj. Thank you, Maharaj.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mariji. Very nice to see you both.
Mariji, please accept this
calling. Yes, thank you very much. Very nice.
Bhakti Swami Maharaj ki
jai. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Om Agyanat Marandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Unmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namaom Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Precharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we are speaking on the significance of this Gundicha Marjanam event taking place today. Gundicha Marjanam, of course. Do we want translation, Prabhu?
Yes, Maharaj. Actually, we have mixed crowd, Maharaj.
Okay.
So with the permission, we'll be translating, Maharaj.
Okay.
So आज हम सब Gundicha Marjan बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण उत्सव पर एकत्रित हुए हैं.
So this Gundicha Marjanam is of course taking place the day before the Rath Yatra. Tomorrow is the Rath Yatra festival. So for 2 weeks Lord Jagannath has been recluse. He's not been giving his darshan to everyone. For 2 weeks he's been away from the altar, and so we've all been missing his presence.
To 2 saptah ke aaspas Jagannath Bhagwan kisi ko darshan nahi dete hain aur hum sabhi unke darshan se vanchit hote hain.
But tomorrow he will bless us, he will appear, and tomorrow we'll have the occasion in Jagannath Puri. They will put Lord Jagannath along with his brother Balaram and sister Subhadra. They will mount their chariots, and their chariots will be pulled to the Gundicha temple.
और कल वो दिवस है जब जगन्नाथ पुरी में भगवान जगन्नाथ बलदेव जी सुभद्रा जी वो गुंडीचा मार्ग जो गुंडीचा मंदिर है वहाँ की ओर प्रस्थान करेंगे और सबको भगवान का दर्शन प्राप्त होगा.
The Gundicha temple is 2 kilometers away from the main temple of Lord Jagannath.
ये 2 किलोमीटर जगन्नाथपुरी के मुख्य मंदिर से दूर है.
And Lord Jagannath, and along with Balaram and Subhadra, they go there and they will stay at the Gundicha temple. They stay there for a week.
और 1 सप्ताह के लिए लगभग वो गुंडीचा मंदिर में जाएंगे और वहाँ पर विश्राम करेंगे.
So the Gundicha temple has not been used for about 1 year because Lord Jagannath only stays there once a year for a week.
तो लगभग एक वर्ष तक यहाँ पर जो गुंडीचा मंदिर है उसमें वो बंद रहता है क्योंकि एक वर्ष में एक ही बार 1 सप्ताह के लिए भगवान जगन्नाथ जी वहाँ पर आते हैं.
And so the temple needs to have a good cleaning. And it's a big festival. The day before Rath Yatra, everybody likes to go and help clean there.
इसलिए उस मंदिर को स्वच्छ करने की आवश्यकता है और सब लोग रथ यात्रा के पहले वहां पर जाते हैं बड़ी चाप मंदिर में और उसकी सफाई करते हैं।
So Lord Chaitanya had left Jagannath Puri for 2 weeks when there was no darshan of Lord Jagannath. He'd gone to Alalanath and stayed there, but then he comes back for the Gundicha Marjanam.
तो चैतन्य भगवान चैतन्य महाप्रभु वो 2 सप्ताह तक हमको दर्शन नहीं मिलता है जगन्नाथपुरी में तो वो अलारनाथ जा करके वहां पर भगवान के दर्शन करते हैं।
And Lord Chaitanya would go to the superintendent of the temple and he would meet with also Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, who was one of the main pandits there in Jagannath Puri, and he would get their permission to do the Gundicha Marjanam with all of his devotees.
और वो मंदिर में आकर के अनास से और वहाँ के जो मंदिर के मुख्य पुजारी हैं और जो वहाँ के महंत हैं जैसे कि सर्वभौम भट्टाचार्य उनसे स्वीकृति लेकर के आज्ञा लेकर के वो मंदिर की सफाई करते हैं।
So the superintendent of the temple was very happy to hear Lord Chaitanya's request and he immediately arranged for 100 brushes to be given along with 100 pots which could be used for carrying water, for cleaning everything.
और मंदिर के जो वहाँ पर जो अथॉरिटी थी उन्हें सुन करके बहुत ही उनको अच्छा लगा उनका विचार और उन्हें चतुर महाप्रभु को 100 से भी ज़्यादा ऐसे सेवक और स्वच्छ करने के लिए जो पात्रों की आवश्यकता थी वो सब उनको प्रदान किए।
Near to the temple of Gundicha, there's a big lake and all the water used for cleaning the Gundicha temple was taken from that lake. It's all brought there in pots. So all the people have to carry the pots.
Gundicha Marjan ke paas mein jo kund hai, wahan se hi jal ko la karke us patra mein us mandir ki safai swachhta ki gayi.
So Lord Chaitanya would lead all of the devotees and by his own example, he would show them all how to clean the temple of Gundicha.
Chatur Mahaprabhu un sabke agrani the aur swayam ke udaharan se sab kuch sikha rahe the kaise bhagwan ke mandir ko swachh karna chahiye wo Gundicha marjan kar rahe the.
And the significance of this cleaning of the Gundicha temple is that it also refers to how we have to clean our own heart.
और इसका एक ये भी महत्व है गुंडिचा मंदिर के मार्जन का कि कैसे हम अपने हृदय को स्वच्छ करें।
Gundicha means also the heart. So just as we have to clean the temple, we want Lord Jagannath to sit comfortably in the temple. Temple has to be very clean. So we want Krishna to sit in our own heart. Our heart has to be clean.
So, Gundicha Marjan mandir jo hai unki tulna yahan par hriday se ki gayi hai jaise hum Gundicha Marjan ko swachh karke bhagwan Jagannath ji ko aamantrit karna chahte hain usi prakar apne hriday ko swachh karke usme bhagwan ko aamantrit karna chahte hain.
So all the devotees came there to the Gundicha temple and they began cleaning and they collected all the dust and all the sand and all the straw, anything which should not be there. They swept it up and collected it up and took it far away.
तो सभी भक्त मिलकर के वहाँ पर चतुर महाप्रभु के मार्गदर्शन में जितनी वहाँ पर धूल थी जो ऐसे तृण थे जो पत्ते थे सूखे वो सभी को उठा करके और वहाँ से दूर ले जा करके उनको फेंका और पूरा मंदिर स्वच्छ कर दिया।
Lord Chaitanya would praise someone if they were cleaning very nicely.
चित्र महाप्रभु लोगों की बहुत वहाँ पर गुणगान करते थे अगर कोई बहुत अच्छे से सफाई कर रहे हैं।
And if someone was not cleaning nicely, Lord Chaitanya would chastise them and say, "No, you don't do it like this. Do it like this," and he'd show them how to clean.
और कोई लोग अच्छे से सफाई नहीं कर पा रहे थे तो उनको वो डांटते भी, तो उनको कहते कि कैसे आप कर रहे हैं और अच्छे से सफाई करिए।
So by his own example, Lord Chaitanya showed us how to clean the temple very carefully.
तो अपने स्वयं के उदाहरण से उन्होंने सबको हम सबको सिखाया कि कैसे बहुत सावधानी पूर्वक मंदिर की स्वच्छता करनी चाहिए, सफाई करनी चाहिए.
They cleaned it, and then they brought the water, and they threw the water everywhere. They cleaned even the ceiling and the walls, as well as all the floors.
तो पूरे मंदिर को स्वच्छ करने के पश्चात वो लोग जल लेके आए उस कुंड से और पूरा जल का छिड़काव करके यहाँ तक कि दीवार और ऊपर की छत वो सब को स्वच्छ किया.
And they lifted up the Singhasan, which is the throne of Lord Jagannath and Lord Balaram and Subhadra Maharani. They lifted up that Simhasan and they cleaned there and they cleaned everything.
और जो सिंहासन थे वहाँ पे जगन्नाथ भगवान बलदेव जी सुभद्रा भैया के उनको उठा करके भी सब कुछ वहाँ पर साफ किया.
They didn't want anything, any dust, anything which should not be there. It should be cleaned, it should be collected and thrown far away.
और सब कुछ कोई भी ऐसा धूल का कण जो वहाँ पर नहीं होना चाहिए उस सब को स्वच्छ करके उसको बाहर बहुत दूर फेंका.
So all the devotees were engaged. Some were sweeping and some were carrying the pots of water.
तो सभी भक्त युक्त थे, कुछ सफाई कर रहे थे, कुछ जल का पात्र लेके आ रहे थे.
And everybody was chanting the holy names everywhere you could hear, Krishna, Krishna.
और सभी लोग वो भगवान के नाम का जप कर रहे थे. सभी जगह पर मंदिर में Krishna, Krishna की ध्वनि आ रही थी.
Sometimes the devotees were carrying the pots to get water, and they would be rushing to bring more water, but in their rush they would bump into somebody coming with water. And their pots would break, and when all you'd hear would be Krishna, Krishna.
और कोई लोग ऐसे जल लेने के लिए जा रहे, दौड़ रहे थे, कोई उधर से जल लेके आ रहे थे, उसे टकराने के बाद वो जल का पात्र गिर जा रहा था, लेकिन सबको Krishna, Krishna ही सुनाई पड़ रहा था.
It's a principle in devotional service that when we are engaged in any kind of devotional service, there must also be the chanting of the holy names.
ये भी बहुत अच्छा सिद्धांत है कि जब हम लोग किसी न किसी भक्ति के अंग में युक्त रहते हैं तो उस समय हमको सदैव भगवान के नाम का जप कीर्तन करते रहना चाहिए.
I was so happy when I came online this evening, the devotees were chanting the holy name. It's very nice. That's important. Before we speak, there should be some kirtan.
Maharaj keh rahe ki jab main yahan par aaj juda aur dekha ki kirtan ho raha hai to main bahut prasann hua. Jab bhi hum kahin par ekatrit ho ki bhagwan ka naam ka kirtan ho raha ho aur uske paschat hame kuch katha ya kuch aise sankarna ho to wo bahut acha hota hai.
And when we're worshipping the deity, there must also be kirtan, there must be the chanting of the holy names.
Usi prakar jab hum bhagwan ke acharya ki seva kar rahe ho tab bhi kirtan hona chahiye, bhagwan ke naam ka jap kirtan hona chahiye.
It's not enough to just worship the deity, we have to also chant the holy name.
To keval acharya ki seva karna, puja karna wahi paryapt nahi hai. हमको भगवान के नाम का सदैव जप करते रहना चाहिए.
So the acharyas explain the chanting of the holy name must be there in all the different activities of devotion.
तो आचार्यगण व्याख्या करते हैं कि भक्ति के सभी अंग में भगवान के नाम का जप कीर्तन होना चाहिए.
The chanting of the holy name is the most important item of devotional service.
भगवान के नाम का जप कीर्तन सबसे महत्वपूर्ण भाग है हमारी आध्यात्मिक सेवा का.
So although Lord Chaitanya and the devotees were engaged in cleaning the temple, at the same time they were all chanting the holy names, and everywhere you could hear Krishna, Krishna. The whole atmosphere was filled with the chanting of the holy names.
तो हालांकि वहां पर सभी लोग स्वच्छता कर रहे थे, सफाई कर रहे थे मंदिर में, लेकिन सभी लोग वहाँ पर भगवान के नाम का जब कीर्तन कृष्णा कृष्णा इसका उच्चारण करते जा रहे थे.
So after they had cleaned the temple one time, then they started to clean it again. And the second cleaning was done more thoroughly, more carefully.
और एक बार जब पूरे मंदिर की सफाई हो गई, फिर दोबारा उन्होंने मंदिर की सफाई करना शुरू किया और वो सफाई और भी सावधानी पूर्वक हुई.
Lord Chaitanya is showing us, if we want Krishna to sit in our heart must be clean. We have to get rid of all the dirty things in the heart.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu यहाँ पर ये प्रस्तुत कर रहे हैं कि अगर हमको अपने हृदय में भगवान को बुलाना है, आमंत्रित करना है, तो हमारा हृदय बहुत स्वच्छ होना चाहिए, सभी अनर्थों से, सभी जो धूल के कण हैं, जो अनर्थ हैं, उससे दूर स्वच्छ होना चाहिए.
So the devotees worked very hard, cleaning again, gathering whatever they could find in the way of sand or dust or straw, anything which shouldn't be there, they swept it up and gathered it. And Lord Chaitanya would come and look and say, yes, you have done very well. And he would say, tell others, oh, you have not done very much, you must work harder, you must try harder.
और इस प्रकार से सभी भक्त मिलकर के वहाँ पर गुंडिचा मंदिर में दोबारा जब स्वच्छ सफाई कर रहे थे तो सभी कुछ धूल के कण, तृण, घास के टुकड़े, कुछ भी जो वहाँ पर पड़े हुए थे वो सबको बिल्कुल स्वच्छ करते गए. और चतुर महाप्रभु आकर के बीच बीच में देखते जा रहे थे और जो बहुत अच्छी सफाई कर रहे थे उनको उनका वाहवाही कर रहे थे कि आपने बहुत अच्छी सफाई की, और जो नहीं कर पा रहे थे उनको बोल रहे थे और अच्छी सफाई करिए आप.
So when everything is neat and clean, and then the marble is very nice and clean, it's very cooling. In the same way, when our heart is clean, then our mind will also be cool.
और जब इस प्रकार से पूरा स्वच्छ हो गया तो उसके पश्चात जो वहाँ पर नीचे जो संगमरमर के पत्थर लगे थे वो भी बड़े शीतल हो गए. उसी प्रकार जो हमारे हृदय की सफाई होती है तो उसके पश्चात हमारा मन जो है वो शीतल हो जाता है.
If we want to be cool-headed, that's why we shave our heads, and keep our hair short. We get our strength, we get spiritual strength by shaving our heads. This is Lord Chaitanya's movement. And Lord Chaitanya didn't have long hair, he kept his hair short. He shaved his head, well, he had his head shaved when he took sannyas.
उसी प्रकार हम लोग को भी हम लोग देखते हैं कि हम लोग कैसे अपने बालों को मुंडन कराते हैं, छोटे बाल रखते हैं, जिससे कि हमारा जो सर हो वो ठंडा रह सके, शीतल रह सके, इससे हमें आध्यात्मिक बल प्रदान होता है. चतुर महाप्रभु के अभियान में देखते हैं चतुर महाप्रभु स्वयं संन्यास के पश्चात वो अपने हमेशा मुंडन का करते थे.
श्रील प्रभुपाद वाज वेरी particular about this because of course when he was there in the West in the 1960s and 70s, young people often had long hair, so Prabhupada would have to tell them to cut their hair and shave their heads. He said this way you will be cool-headed.
Shri Prabhupada jab the usme paschat deshon mein 1965 ke aas paas uske paschat aur jab dekha us samay wahan par log bade bade baal rakhte the तो श्री पापा जी कहते थे कि सब लोग अपने बालों को मुंडन कराइए क्योंकि हमको अपने सर को ठंडा रखना चाहिए.
So cleaning the temple, making the marble nice and clean and shining, then it's very cooling. In the same way, when we get rid of all the material desires from our heart, we will feel also cool.
तो पूरे मंदिर की स्वच्छता करके जब उन्होंने पूरे मार्बल को स्वच्छ किया तो मार्बल पूरे बिल्कुल ठंडे हो गए वहाँ पर. उसी प्रकार जो अपने हृदय की हम सफाई करते हैं तो हमारा मन भी सर बिल्कुल शांत हो जाता है, ठंडा हो जाता है.
So we want to understand what are these material desires which are covering the heart? What is these material desires? We call them anarthas, and we want to identify them, and then we can remove them.
इसलिए हम लोग समझना चाहते हैं कि वो क्या है जो हमारे हृदय के अंदर आच्छादित हो जाते हैं, वो क्या हमारी भौतिक इच्छाएं हैं जिसको हम अनर्थ कह रहे हैं, जिनको हम स्वच्छ करना चाहते हैं.
Lord Chaitanya has spoken about cleaning the heart in his Shikshastikam prayers. In the very first verse, he says, Cheto Darpanam Marjanam. He compares the heart to a mirror, and the mirror is covered by dust. And that dust is just like our material desires.
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu apne Shikshastikam prarthna mein is baat ko ingit karte hain pehli prarthna mein ki hamara hriday jo hai wo ek darpan ke jaise hai aur us par dhool ka jamna wo hamari bhautik ichhaein uske badal jam jati hain uske samaan.
In Srimad Bhagavatam also we read Sutta Goswami speaking to the sages of Naimisharanya, and he is telling them, Shrinvatam Svakata Krishna Punya Shravana Kirtana Ridyanta Stohiya Badrani Vidunoti Suritsatam. That Lord Krishna is the Super Soul in the hearts of all living entities, and he cleanses the desire for material enjoyment from those who relish his message, which in itself is virtuous when properly heard and chanted.
Srimad Bhagavatam mein Sud Goswami ji Vishwanath Adarishma se batate hain ki kis prakar Bhagwan ke naam ke shravan aur kirtan se hriday ke andar upasthit jitne bhi abhadr hain unko turant hi dur kar diya jata hai.
So the process of cleaning the heart is this devotional service based on hearing and chanting.
To hriday ko swachh karne ki jo vidhi hai wo hai shravan aur kirtan ki vidhi.
But we want to understand first of all what are we trying to clear from the heart. We don't just have sand and dust and straw like in the temple. But within our heart, we have the different anarthas, the things which are obstructing our devotion to Krishna.
So we have to understand what we want to do in our heart. There is no dhool, karn, aise, ghaas ke tukde, ye nahi hai. Yahan par wo anarth jo hamari bhautik ichhaen, prabal ichhaen hai, jo hamare bhakti mein, jeevan mein badha hai, unko hum dur karna chahte hain.
So there are four different kinds of anarthas. First of all, we have material desires. Material desires are like the desire for economic development or the desire for liberation. Karma, or we simply want mukti.
तो सबसे ये हमें चार प्रकार के जो अनर्थ बताए गए यहाँ पर सबसे पहले हैं ये जो इच्छा है हमारी जो भौतिक इच्छाएं हैं जैसे कि कर्म मुक्ति की इच्छा ये जो हमारी भौतिक इच्छाएं हैं जो धर्म अर्थ काम मोक्ष हम समझते हैं इस प्रकार से वो जो इच्छाएं हमारे अंदर हैं.
Material desires, we know that they're always temporary, they're not going to last forever. We may get some economic success, we may get some pleasures in the material world. It's all temporary, it's not eternal.
लेकिन ये जो भौतिक इच्छाएं हैं ये सब अस्थाई हैं अशाश्वत हैं जैसे कि जो हमारे अर्थ हैं या फिर जो काम की भावना ये सब जो है क्षणिक है ये.
And similarly the desire for liberation, for mukti is also not going to give us eternal liberation. It's simply going to take us into the Brahma Jyoti, and after some time we will come back from there.
और उसी प्रकार जो मुक्ति की अभिलाषा है वो भी क्षणिक है क्योंकि ब्रह्म ज्योति तक जाकर के और वापस पुनः आना होगा.
Then the second kind of anartha is what we call Hridaya Durbhavyam, or the weakness of the heart. The weakness of the heart is the tendency to give up our spiritual practice and to deviate from our spiritual practice. Like sometimes we make vows and we don't keep them.
और दूसरे प्रकार का अनर्थ जो है उसको हृदय दुर्बलता कहते हैं. हृदय दुर्बलता जिसका अर्थ है कि अपनी जो आध्यात्मिक जो संकल्प हमने लिया है उसमें हम चित हो जाते हैं और आध्यात्मिक कार्यकलापों को करने में हमारी शक्ति क्षीण हो जाती है, हम उसको नहीं कर पाते हैं। बहुत संकल्प देते हैं लेकिन कर नहीं पाते।
The weakness of the heart may also be seen in the tendency to be envious of others, and to be envious of others is to stop the preaching work.
और हृदय की दुर्बलता और भी देखी जाती है जब दूसरों से ईर्ष्या भाव रखते हैं, और जिससे कि हम जो प्रचार प्रसार का कार्य है उसमें भी हमारी शिथिलता हो जाती
है। चैतन्य महाप्रभु taught us the importance of para upakar. He would say, barata bhumite haila manushya janma ja janma sartaka karikara para upakar. That one who is born in Varadvarsh should make his life successful, make his life perfect, become Krishna conscious, and then preach and give Krishna consciousness to others.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu kehte hain ki jiska bhi janma Bharat mein hua hai, उनको स्वयं कृष्ण भावना भावित होकर के अपना जीवन सार्थक करना चाहिए और फिर दूसरों को कृष्ण भावना भावित जीवन देकर के उनका उपकार करना चाहिए।
So devotee is caring, compassionate on others, and he will want to preach. He should not be envious, shouldn't have bad feelings towards others.
इसलिए करुणामय भाव से कृपा करते हुए दूसरों को ये प्रचार प्रसार करना चाहिए कृष्ण भावना भावित जीवन के लिए, उनके प्रति कुछ बुरा भाव या ईर्ष्या नहीं रखनी चाहिए।
Another weakness of the heart is the desire to get profit, adoration, distinction, to get some big position, to be worshipped and honored by others.
और तीसरा जो अर्थ है जिसको कि पूजा, लाभ, प्रतिष्ठा, दूसरों से सम्मान मिले, इस प्रकार की अभिलाषा मन में होना।
So devotee is very careful to avoid these things. He doesn't want to find fault with others. Rather, he will see his own faults.
तो भक्त लोग बड़े सावधान होते हैं इसके प्रति। वो दूसरों में दोष नहीं देखते, अपने स्वयं के दोषों को ढूंढते हैं।
Then another kind of anartha in the heart are offenses, aparad, things like Vaishnava aparad, when we offend the devotees, or Seva aparad, when we're worshipping the deities and we're not worshipping the deities properly, we're not following the rules and regulations, or it may be Nama aparad in our chanting.
और तीस जो चौथा जो बताया गया यहाँ पर जो अनर्थ है वो है अपराध, जिसमें कि नाम के प्रति अपराध, जो भगवान के सेवा विग्रह अर्चक हैं उनके प्रति सेवा का अपराध, इस प्रकार से जो अपराध हो सकते हैं और वैष्णव के प्रति अपराध।
So these apparads, they create obstacles, they can greatly damage our creeper of devotion. Even if we offend the devotees, it can destroy the creeper of devotion.
तो ये अपराध जो होते हैं ये हमारे भक्ति लता बीज को बिल्कुल नष्ट कर सकते हैं, यहाँ तक कि श्री वैष्णव के प्रति अपराध हमारे भक्ति लता बीज को नष्ट कर सकते हैं।
And then the final of aparad, the final anartha, unwanted is where we have the wrong philosophy, that we misunderstand the goal and we're thinking maybe the goal is impersonal monism, or merging, becoming one, or even giving up our identity, losing our identity and becoming nothing.
और अंतिम जो यहाँ पर बताया गया जो अनर्थ है वो है तत्व विभ्रम, जिसमें कि अपने आप की पहचान ठीक से नहीं कर पाना और ये समझना कि मैं भगवान में विलीन हो जाऊँगा, अपने अस्तित्व को अपनी पहचान को ठीक से नहीं समझ पाना, उस तत्व को नहीं समझ पाना।
So we offer our respectful obeisances to Srila Prabhupada in his pranam mantra that he is preaching the message of Lord Chaitanya to destroy the darkness of impersonalism and voidism. because these two philosophies are prominent in the world today, so it's very important people need to hear about Lord Chaitanya's teachings. And people sometimes are affected by apasampradayas. They may feel that they're following Lord Chaitanya, but they're connected to some other sampradaya where they have some other mantra or something. That's also another wrong philosophy that creates more anarthas, disturbs the heart.
और उसी प्रकार से ऐसे अपसंप्रदाय भी वो लगता है कि वो कहते हैं कि वो चैतन्य महाप्रभु के ही इस अभियान में है लेकिन वो कुछ और मंत्र का उच्चारण करना और जप करना और विधि से कुछ करना तो ये अपसंप्रदाय है ये भी गलत सिद्धांत है
So long as these different anarthas are there in the heart, then there's going to be disturbance in the heart. And it's not going to be a very comfortable place for Lord Krishna to sit.
जब तक ये अनर्थ हृदय के अंदर उपस्थित हैं, तो ये हृदय के अंदर विचलन उत्पन्न करेंगे और भगवान श्री कृष्ण को वहां पर विराजने के लिए उचित स्थान नहीं होगा
If Lord, just like we know, Lord Krishna is the Supreme Lord, we don't want him to just sit anywhere. We want to give him a proper respect. You want to give him the good seat. You want to make everything nice and clean. And so Lord Krishna has come to reside in our heart and we have to keep that heart. We have to really clean that heart.
जैसे भगवान श्री कृष्ण परमपुरुषोत्तम भगवान हैं महाप्रभु उनको हम कहीं पर भी किसी भी स्थान पर नहीं बिठाना चाहते उनको हम बहुत अच्छे स्वच्छ उचित स्थान पर बिठाना चाहते हैं इसीलिए हमारे हृदय के अंदर हम उनको अगर आमंत्रित करना चाहते हैं तो हमारा हृदय ये मलिन नहीं होना चाहिए अनर्थों से विमुक्त होना चाहिए पूर्ण से स्वच्छ होना चाहिए जिसके लिए वो भगवान के लिए उचित स्थान बन सके वहां पर बैठने के लिए
चैतन्य महाप्रभु पर्सनली शोड अस द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ क्लीनिंग द हार्ट बाय हाउ ही क्लीन्ड द गुंडीचा टेंपल एंड ही पर्सनली शोड अस ही क्लीन्ड द टेंपल ट्वाइस द सेकंड टाइम मोर केयरफुली
और चैतन्य महाप्रभु स्वयं अपने उदाहरण से सिखा रहे हैं कि कितना महत्वपूर्ण है अपने हृदय को स्वच्छ करना और वो गुंडीचा मार्जन के मंदिर को दो बार सफाई करते हैं ये शिक्षा देने के लिए हम सबको
They not only cleaned the temple inside, they cleaned outside also and they made sure everything was put far away that it would not come back in again.
और मंदिर को सिर्फ अंदर से ही नहीं बल्कि बाहर से भी सफाई किया संगतों ने मिलकर के और जितने भी वहां पर गंदगी थी उनको बहुत दूर जाके फेंका दोबारा वो गंदगियां वहां पर मंदिर में नहीं आ सके
चैतन्य महाप्रभु इवन टुक हिज ओन क्लॉथ एंड यूज्ड हिज ओन क्लॉथ टू क्लीन एवरीथिंग
चैतन्य महाप्रभु ने स्वयं अपने वस्त्र को लेकर के सब कुछ सफाई किया साफ किया मंदिर
सो The obvious question which will come to us is, how do we know if our heart is clean or not? How do we know if our heart is actually clean? Can we actually understand if we've actually got rid of all these things from the heart?
तो स्वाभाविक प्रश्न आएगा हमारे मन में कि क्या कैसे हमको ज्ञात होगा कि हमारा हृदय स्वच्छ हो गया है? कैसे हमें ज्ञात होगा?
So we can understand how much we have cleaned the heart and how much we're free of these anarthas in the heart by how much taste we have developed for hearing and chanting the message of the Supreme Lord Krishna.
तो ये हमें ऐसे ज्ञात होगा कि कितना हमारा हृदय स्वच्छ हो गया है, कितना हमारा हृदय अनर्थों से दूर हो गया है। कि कितना रुचि हमको आ रहा है भगवान के संदेश कथा को श्रवण और कीर्तन करने के लिए
If we have developed a very strong taste, we're very eager to chant and to hear about Krishna, and we have lost all interest in other things, then this is very good. This means your heart is maybe free of material desires.
तो अगर हमारे अंदर बहुत उत्सुकता से रुचि आ रही है भगवान के नाम रूप लीला के श्रवण कीर्तन में और बाकी जो अलग अद्वितीय जो वस्तुएं हैं उनके अंदर हमारी कोई युक्ति नहीं है, कोई रुचि नहीं है बाकी किसी चीजों में, तब हम समझ सकते हैं कि हमारा हृदय स्वच्छ हो रहा है.
Of course, most of you have you're all working there. You have jobs. You're busy. You don't get a lot of time. You have to keep your mind somehow engaged in thinking of Krishna.
महाराज कहते हैं कि जैसे यहाँ पर बहुत से लोग कार्यों में व्यस्त रहते हैं, कार्यकलाप करते रहते हैं, कार्य कर रहे हैं, व्यवसाय कर रहे हैं, लेकिन हम सबको प्रयास करना होगा कि हमारा मन जो है वो भगवान के चिंतन में लगा रहे.
So the process of bhakti yoga begins with shraddha, faith. We have to have faith in Lord Krishna and faith in the teachings of the acharyas and apply yourself to the process.
तो भक्ति योग का आरंभ होता है श्रद्धा से, भगवान पर श्रद्धा रखना और आचार्य गण की शिक्षाओं पर आचार कर उनके ऊपर श्रद्धा रख करके अपने जीवन में उसको अपनाना, प्रयोग करना.
When we have good faith, then we want to chant, we want to follow the principles, we want to do everything which we're supposed to do, and we want to also have the association of other devotees.
जब हमें श्रद्धा होती है तो हम जब कीर्तन में रुचि लेते हैं और अन्य भक्तों का संग करना चाहते हैं.
So the process of Gundicha Marjana is helping people who are new in devotional service to develop faith in the chanting process. And for those people who are more advanced, then the Gundicha Marjana process is helping us to purify us, to get rid of the anarthas so that we can come to the higher stages of devotion.
तो गुंडीचा का मार्जन का जो महत्व है, विशेष रूप से जो नौसिखी भक्त उनके लिए किस प्रकार से वो श्रद्धा उत्पन्न करें भगवान और आचार्यों की शिक्षाओं में, और जो उन्नत भक्त हैं उनके लिए कैसे वो और शुद्ध हो, उनके हृदय से अनर्थों की निवृत्ति हो जिससे उनको और आनंद रुचि मिले भगवान के नाम कीर्तन श्रवण.
लॉर्ड चैतन्य महाप्रभु इज द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड हिमसेल्फ. ही डजंट हैव टू क्लीन द हार्ट बट टू टीच अस ऑल बाय हिज एग्जांपल. He took part in this program and he would come and clean the temple, Gundicha, and he would clean it very carefully, even using his own cloth.
To Bhagwan Chaitanya Mahaprabhu swayam Bhagwan unko avashyakta nahi hai apne hriday ko swachh karne ke liye, lekin wo sab kuch sikha rahe hain is madhyam se, swayam aakar ke Gundicha marjan ka, Gundicha mandir ka marjan kar rahe hain do do baar savadhani purvak aur apne swayam ke vastron ko upyog karte hain.
In the course of Lord Chaitanya cleaning the temple, there were a couple of interesting pastimes took place which are described in the Chaitanya Charitamrita.
Aur Gundicha jo mandir hai uska marjan karte hue Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki leela mein to badi mahatvapurna leelaen hui hai jinko Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita mein sambodhit kiya gaya.
One devotee came with a pot of water and he poured the water on the feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And after washing the feet of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then he took some of that water in his mouth and drank it. So Lord Chaitanya internally was pleased, but externally he displayed some anger.
तो एक भक्त वो पात्र में जल लेकर के आए और चैतन्य महाप्रभु के चरणों का अभिषेक करने लगे और वो अभिषेक करके वो जल का उन्होंने पान कर लिया. चैतन्य महाप्रभु आंतरिक रूप से तो प्रसन्न थे लेकिन बाह्य रूप से वो बहुत क्रोधित हो रहे थे.
Internally he was pleased because he understood this devotee was eager to get Krishna consciousness, to awaken his love for Krishna. But externally he was angry because he knew that what the devotee had done was not the proper etiquette, that you don't wash somebody's feet in the temple.
To aantrik rup se prasan the ki dekho ye krishna bhavana bhavit जो उसकी जो जागृत अवस्था है उसको प्राप्त करने के लिए इस प्रकार का प्रयास कर रहे हैं विष्णु की सेवा, लेकिन वो बाहर रूप से इसलिए अप्रसन्न थे कि जो उन्होंने किया ये उचित व्यवहार नहीं है, क्योंकि मंदिर में किसी के और के चरण कमल धोना ये उचित नहीं है।
So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was appearing as a devotee, and he wanted that other people there would also consider him a devotee of Krishna. In the temple, we give the love and we offer the respect to the deity, and to worship someone else, to worship a devotee in the temple, is not to proper etiquette.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu bhakt roop mein avatarit hue hain aur bhakt ka aacharan kar rahe hain, wo chahte hain ki sab unke bhakt ke roop mein samman kare, isliye मंदिर में भगवान के विग्रह के समक्ष सिर्फ भगवान के अर्चा विग्रह का ही गुणगान और उनकी सेवा होनी चाहिए। सुनने चाहते थे कि उनके समक्ष वो उनका गुणगान करें।
So Lord Chaitanya called another senior devotee and told him that this person has done, and the person who was in charge, he took that person and he put him out of the temple. He said, you cannot stay in the temple, you're not behaving properly.
और तब चैतन्य महाप्रभु के अनुसार भक्तों ने उनको बाहर ले गए वहां मंदिर से और कहा कि जो आपने किया है ये व्यवहार मंदिर के अंदर ही उचित नहीं।
So Lord Chaitanya was teaching all of us it's important to follow the etiquette and the rules and regulations in the temple.
तो चैतन्य महाप्रभु अपने स्वयं के आचरण से वैष्णव सदाचार क्या होता है, कैसे मंदिर के अंदर व्यवहार करना चाहिए, उसकी शिक्षा दे रहे हैं।
Another pastime which took place was after they cleaned the temple, Lord Chaitanya began kirtan, and they were all chanting and dancing. Then Lord Chaitanya asked the son of Advaita Acharya, who was a young boy named Gopal, he asked Gopal that you chant. I want to see you chant and dance, Gopal.
उसके बाद चैतन्य महाप्रभु ने वहाँ पर कीर्तन करना शुरू किया और अद्वैत आचार्य के जो पुत्र थे गोपाल उनको बोले कि आप नृत्य करिए, आप गाइए।
So Gopal, young boy, began to chant and dance, and he was dancing ecstatically. But suddenly he collapsed, and fell unconscious. And when his father came there to see him, Advaita Acharya came. He was shocked to see that Gopal was no longer breathing even.
और गोपाल जो है बहुत ही नवयुवक थे और बहुत सुंदर नृत्य कर रहे थे, गा रहे थे। कुछ समय के पश्चात वो गिर पड़े वहाँ पर मंदिर के अंदर ही, और तो आचार्य आए देखे तो अरे उनके अंदर तो बिल्कुल भी चेतना नहीं थी उस समय।
And the devotees were all really worried. They thought Gopal has left his body. But then Lord Chaitanya came, and Lord Chaitanya placed his hand on the chest of Gopal and said, get up, Gopal, get up and chant the holy name. And immediately Gopal came to consciousness and stood up and began chanting.
तभी चैतन्य महाप्रभु वहाँ पर आते हैं और वो अपने हस्तकमल को उनके छाती पर रखते हैं और कहते हैं कि गोपाल उठो, उठो गोपाल, नृत्य करो। और तुरंत ही गोपाल उठ करके फिर गायन और नृत्य करना शुरू कर देते हैं।
So those are two leelas which took place during the cleaning of the Gundicha temple, but the main message from this cleaning of the Gundicha temple is the importance of cleaning our own heart and getting rid of all the unwanted things from the heart.
ये दो लीलाएं बताई गई चैतन्य-चरितामृत में जो कि गुंडिचा मार्च के समय हुई, लेकिन विशेष महत्व है इस लीला का कि किस प्रकार से अपने हृदय को हमें स्वच्छ करना चाहिए, अनर्थों को दूर करना चाहिए।
And this is compared to the process of anartha nivritti. That we want to remove the anarthas from the heart. And anartha nivritti is one of the stages in devotional service.
और इसकी तुलना अनर्थ निवृत्ति से की जाती है गुंडिचा मार्जन की, जिससे कि हम अनर्थों से दूर होना चाहते हैं, जो हमारी भक्ति में जो क्रमिक विकास है उसमें आता है.
We begin with faith, Shraddha, and that brings us into the association of devotees, Sadhu Sangha. And then we come to Bhajana Kriya, where we take up the activities of devotion.
तो भक्ति की शुरुआत आरंभ श्रद्धा से होती है, वो हमको साधु संघ में लेके आते हैं, और फिर भजन क्रिया, और भजन क्रिया फिर हमको अनर्थ निवृत्ति के रूप में करती है.
Usually during the stage of Bhajana Kriya, this time people will receive initiation from a spiritual master. And then they will go on to do anartha nivritti, to remove all the unwanted things from the heart.
और भजन क्रिया के स्तर पर भक्तगण वो दीक्षा ग्रहण करते हैं, आध्यात्मिक गुरु का आश्रय ग्रहण करते हैं, और उसके पश्चात वो अनर्थ निवृत्ति की ओर उन्मुख होते हैं, अनर्थों को दूर करने का प्रयास करते हैं.
And when we get rid of these anarthas, then we can go on to the higher stages of devotion. Like nishta, becoming very fixed and steady, and then ruchi, and tasting the pleasure of devotional service, and then going to asakti, being fully detached from all the material affairs of the world, and that leads us into bhava and prema.
और उस प्रकार से अनर्थवृत्ति होने के पश्चात फिर उनको निष्ठा के स्तर पर वो आते हैं, और उसके पश्चात फिर रुचि, जैसा भी हमने सुना भगवान के नाम रूप लीला में, उसके पश्चात आसक्ति, और उसके पश्चात वो भाव और प्रेम के स्तर तक पहुंच पाते हैं.
So this process of anartha nivritti is the most demanding of all the parts of the devotional process. It's very difficult and challenging for us to remove all these undirty things out of our heart.
ये जो प्रक्रिया है अनर्थ निवृत्ति की, ये बहुत ही अपेक्षित है और बहुत ही चुनौतीपूर्वक भी है हमारे हृदय से अनर्थों को पूर्ण रूप से दूर करने के लिए.
And often we find that after some time, when we think we've got rid of material desires, they come back on us again. They grow up again.
कई बार ऐसा होता है कि लगता है कि हमारे हृदय से अनर्थों की निवृत्ति हो चुकी है, लेकिन फिर कुछ समय के पश्चात अनर्थ वापस हमारे हृदय के अंदर आच्छादित हो जाते हैं.
We have to understand that the process of removing material desires is not done by just simply doing some good karma activities or even just by cultivating knowledge. We have to cultivate real devotion for the Supreme Lord.
हमें समझना होगा कि अनर्थों की निवृत्ति इस प्रकार से, ये कुछ केवल ऐसी जो प्रक्रिया है कर्मकांडी विचारधारा है, ऐसे कुछ पुण्य कर्म करने से ये दूर नहीं होंगे, बल्कि हमको शुद्ध रूप से भक्ति में जीवन में इंगित होना होगा.
So we want to avoid falling down, becoming again victim to our material desires. We have to really focus on very carefully hearing and chanting.
तो अपनी भौतिक इच्छाओं से प्रभावित होकर के हम इस मार्ग से हम लोग पतन अपना पतन रोकने के लिए बड़ी गंभीरता से हमको भगवान के श्रवण कीर्तन में युक्त होना.
And if somehow we're not able to really get rid of these material desires, then we have to take up something which is very, very powerful, and that is giving service to Guru and Krishna and Vaishnavas. When we do seva for Krishna and Vaishnavas and spiritual teachers, then that is very, very powerful, and that helps us to get free of these material desires.
अगर हम अपने भौतिक इच्छाओं से के प्रभाव को कम नहीं कर पा रहे हैं, तो महाराज बता रहे हैं कि हमको सेवा में युक्त होना चाहिए, वैष्णव की सेवा, आध्यात्मिक गुरु की सेवा. जब ऐसी सेवा में युक्त होते हैं तो ये बड़ा प्रभावशाली एक ये विधि है, उपाय है, जिससे कि हम अपनी भौतिक इच्छाओं का जो प्रभाव है उससे हम बच सकते हैं.
We want to clean the heart. We want to remember the goal is to develop love for God. That is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wants to give all of us. He wants us to develop our love for Krishna.
हम लोग अपने हृदय के जो अनर्थ है उनको दूर करना चाहते हैं। चित्र महाप्रभु हमको ये सिखा रहे हैं इस गुणिता मार्जन से, जिससे कि हम भगवान कृष्ण के प्रति प्रेम उत्पन्न कर सकें।
But we get tricked by Maya. Instead of taking shelter of Krishna, we take shelter of Maya.
लेकिन हम माया के द्वारा प्रभावित हो जाते हैं, माया के चंगुल में। हमको भगवान श्री कृष्ण की शरण लेने की बजाय हम माया की शरण लेते हैं।
And Maya is a very cunning, crooked witch. And she will fool us. She will, what we think is going to be happiness is going to be distress. And what we think is going to give us shelter will not give us any shelter. Maya is that kind of person.
तो माया जो है वो उस प्रकार से एक क्रूर निर्दयी जो पिशाची है, जो लगता हमको ऐसा दिखाती है कि जो हमारे आनंद नहीं देने वाले हैं वो हमको आनंद देंगे, और जो हमारे आश्रय नहीं होने चाहिए वो हमारे आश्रय हैं, ऐसे हमको सिखाते हैं।
So we have to be really careful not to surrender to Maya, but to surrender to Krishna by always taking shelter of the devotional activities.
इसलिए हमको बहुत सावधान होना चाहिए कि माया की शरणागति नहीं लेकर के हम भगवान की शरणागति लें, और सदैव आध्यात्मिक जो भौतिक जो भक्तिमय जीवन है उसमें युक्त होकर के।
Okay, so we'll stop and ask if there's some questions.
तो महाराज कह रहे कि यहाँ पर हम लोग विराम करेंगे, और कोई अगर प्रश्न होंगे तो हम ले सकते हैं। किसी को अगर जिज्ञासा है, कोई प्रश्न है तो अपने हाथ खड़े कर सकते हैं। महाराज थैंक यू सो मच महाराज, इन सच अ लिमिटेड टाइम द एंटायर पास्ट टाइम सो वंडरफुल यू डायरेक्टेड महाराज, इंक्लूडिंग the significance of this Gunditja Mahajan and how you connected with this anarthas which are there in the heart of the sadhaka, and how it even also compared the sadhak bhakta and even the advanced devotees, how we can get derive the lesson from this Gunditja Mahajan, and beautifully narrated Maharaj this four anarthas also, very nicely explained, and also the way out that how we can get rid of this by taking shelter of the devotional service. So very grateful to you Maharaj. So wonderfully described the entire pastime and significance in our life as a sadhaka, very practical way. Mataji, you can unmute yourself for the question, and Vasanta Prabhu, please.
Maharaj, Dandavat Pranams. Thank you so much. Pranams to all the devotees assembled also. Maharaj, my question is, when did this Ratha Yatra actually begin? What I understand is that the mood of performing the Ratha Yatra, Jagannath is Krishna and he is going to Gunditja Mahajan, that is considered as Vrindavan. I think that mood was inculcated in us through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But Rath Yatra is conducted, I don't know from when. So, this is my question, Maharaj. From when it started and what mood would be, what could be the reason for them to do it?
Yes.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Yes, thank you for your question, Maharaj-ji. Rath Yatra, Srila Prabhupada told us that the first Rath Yatra actually took place at Kurukshetra. And he said, Prabhupada told us, he said, Kurukshetra is important for two things. He said, one was for the speaking
of... The recording has stopped.
One was for the speaking of the Bhagavad Gita, and the other was for Rath Yatra. And he said, the first Rath Yatra took place at Kurukshetra, when the gopis came there to meet Lord Krishna. So, the gopis, of course, were not satisfied with Krishna at Kurukshetra, and they wanted to take him to Vrindavan. So that means Rath Yatra was there 5,000 years ago.
Okay.
When Lord Krishna.
Okay.
But as far as the big Rath Yatra there in Puri, when did that begin? Well, the history of the Jagannath Puri temple goes back, at least the big temple was constructed more than 1,000 years ago. And we think of Maharaj Indrajumna. Maharaj Indrajumna, that's a couple of thousand years ago.
That was in Satyuga. Maharaj Indrajumna was in Satyuga, right, Maharaj?
Indrajumna, is he Satya Yuga? Well, he'd gone away, remember? He'd gone to in the Leela describes how Indrajumna for some time he'd gone away and then he came back and everybody had disappeared. Difficult to put time on these things, even difficult to put an exact time on how long the Jagannath Puri temple has been there.
Okay.
But we know the Daitas, these Sabaras people, the Daitas, they're given the service, they have the service of taking care of Lord Jagannath. So that definitely has to come from that time, because Lord Jagannath was their deity, and they brought the Lord Jagannath there from the, or he had appeared anyway. Initially they were worshipping the other form of the Lord, but then the Lord wanted to be worshipped in a different way, and so he appeared as Jagannath, and the Subharas, the Daitas, they're given the service. And when Lord Jagannath is in recluse for 2 weeks, they're the ones who take care of Lord Jagannath. And they give him all his refreshments and meals and everything. And they're the ones who carry the deity onto the chariot when he reappears. And they're also the ones to make the Mangal Aarti offering to the deities every day. So these Sabara people, they have a very strong connection there with the worship of the deities. And even when Shankaracharya came there, he couldn't do anything about it. He didn't like the worship that they were doing. He did not according to scriptures and like this, And he wanted to change everything. And the king of Puri was affected because Shankaracharya was very influential. Oh no, not Shankaracharya, Ramanuja, right? Ramanuja. Yeah, Ramanuja. So Ramanuja, that's 1,000 years ago, that he came there about 1,000 years ago, and he wanted to change the method of worship. But Lord Jagannath didn't want it, and that's why Ramanuja woke up in Kurmakshetra. In Kurmakshetra, he woke up, and he was surprised to find himself in Kurmakshetra. But Lord Jagannath had transported him out of Puri because he didn't want anybody interfering in his worship. So Lord Jagannath, he really takes care of everything. You know, if somebody's opposed, if somebody's against his worship, then he gets him out of that place. If there's some atheist, some nasty person there who's really against Lord Jagannath, then he'll be told to get out of Puri. That they don't want him. We don't want that person staying in Puri. He has to get out. And so Lord Jagannath is very strict like that. And he's very strict about who he allows it to stay in his dham. But as far as the time goes, at least more than 1,000 years, right? Must be how many thousand years, we don't know.
Thank you, Maharaj. Maharaj, do you have time for one more question?
Yes.
Okay. Maharaj, one question is that in the past time we understand that the deity Nilamadav, whom the Shabaras were worshipping, he disappeared and then he tells that I will come in the wooden form and then the carving has to happen and all that. But the deity is still there. And we had a discussion also more than two years ago. So then how do we understand that?
Nilamadav?
Yes. On top of the hill. And they were saying the deity was from Satyuga and all that. But this question was there in my mind. The Lord disappears. And when the king gets dejected and then he says, no, I will come again in Daru Brahman form. And then you will have to do the needful.
Well,
I don't know.
I've never heard about this before. I've never heard that Nilamadava is the actual deity, original deity of Nilamadava is actually there. I'd always understood also that Nilamadava disappeared, didn't manifest it anymore. But you don't know. I mean, sometimes people, they do these things, they bring a deity and they say this and that. You don't know how genuine it is. It's difficult to understand, difficult to know, but I've never heard before that there was a deity there. We never heard this before. We never heard Gaur Govinda Maharaj speak anything about this. Now, Gaur Govinda Maharaj, he was his whole life a devotee of Jagannath, and he was from that, near his home is near there in Orissa. And I would think he would definitely know about it, you know, but he never mentioned anything about it.
Okay. Thank you, Maharaj. Please accept my humble obeisances and
you. Hare Krishna.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you for your concern.
Thank you for your questions.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna. I'm sorry, Prabhu, did you want translation on this?
No, Maharaj, it's fine, Maharaj. Now we can take, Maharaj, one more question.
Yes, please.
One Mataji and Prabhuji. Amit Prabhu.
It's not a question, Maharaj. Actually, we prepared some praksadam for you, so we just wanted to offer you that.
No, okay. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Maharaj, actually, we thought there aren't any more questions, so...
Yes,
Oh, very nice. Thank you.
Please accept it.
Wonderful.
Thank you for accepting it, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna. I can eat with my eyes.
Hare Krishna.
Maharaj, you are so merciful.
Hare Krishna. Lord Jagannath is the most merciful. So tomorrow, of course, is Ratha Yatra Day.
Vasanta Prabhu, do you have some question? We have raised your hand, please.
Hare Krishna. That is Pranam Maharaj. Please accept my humble obeisance. And thank you very much for your wonderful class, Maharaj. We learned about the word Anartha Nivrati, how to remove our anarthas from our heart. And Maharaj, my question is, during your class, you have mentioned one devotee was washing the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lotus feet and he was drinking the water. So, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is internally happy, but externally he was not happy. So, nowadays, Maharaj, we are seeing in India, most of the places in South India, we have this. In the temple, there is marriage ceremonies and this Upanayan Samskar ceremonies where the father has to wash the his son feet also. During marriage ceremony also, father-in-law will wash the feet of his son-in-law. So this type of ritual is still going on. So is it advisable to conduct the marriages like this in the temples? So this was my question.
Well, I think it's advisable that in such these events, they close the curtains. If they're going to wash someone's feet, then they should do it either with the curtains closed or in some other room. They shouldn't do it in the temple. It's not, certainly it's not proper, not the etiquette. It's not something for the temple. Temple is for worship of the deity. And
thank you, Maharaj.
Now, of course, we also worship like Srila Prabhupada. In the temple room, we worship Srila Prabhupada, right? Srila Prabhupada is the founder Acharya. So we do Srila Prabhupada's Guru Puja, and like that, we may bathe Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada's a very, very, very great soul. He's a founder Acharya. And so we can worship him in the temple room because he's very dear to Lord Krishna. But we don't just worship anybody. And even the devotees, our own ISKCON spiritual masters, they don't do their Guru Puja in the temple room every day. One day in a year only they can have some puja in the temple. And that should be like their Vyasa Puja, but not regularly. So there's restrictions even for the spiritual masters, for the living spiritual masters. And generally, the rule is they'll do these things outside the temple. They won't do it in the temple. Yeah? Understand, Prabhu?
Thank you so much, Maharaj.
Thank you so much, Maharaj. We'll be very, very grateful to you, Maharaj, for so wonderfully narrating this wonderful pastime and the significance in our life, Maharaj, especially the Nartavirti. It was so practical and so many lessons we learned today. And with your blessing, Maharaj, we'll try also, Maharaj, to practice this what we learned today.
Thank you very much, Prabhu.
Maharaj will accept gratitude.
Thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to associate with the devotees there. I'm very happy to be with you all again on the virtual platform.
Thank you so much, Maharaj.
I hope you're all safe there.
Yes, Maharaj. With all the blessing, Maharaj, everybody's safe. Thank you so much.
Thank
so
you.
Altogether, we'll thank Maharaj by chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra and Vaishnava Pranam. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Vanchha Kalpataru, Vrcha Kripa Sindhu, Deva Vrcha. Patitarnam Pavanevru, Vaishnevru, Namo Namaha.
Jai.
Bhakti Vipriminasana Swami Maharaj ki jai.
Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Kanaya Desh ki jai. Hare Krishna.